You may have heard the story of this baby being born in a manger to a poor Jewish carpenter betrothed to a virgin teenager. Matthew chose to mention the wise men and the star of Bethlehem, while Luke described the awestruck shepherds and there being no room in the inn. The nativity of this babe foretold by prophets many years ago that God in flesh would come to walk with sinners while performing signs and miracles. But the real meaning of this birth is often forgotten. In most cases, it's commercialized and filled with jingles and stockings. The real meaning is hidden and put aside, that Jesus, the Son of God, was born to die. Reflect on the blessing of what God did when he slid this flesh on. He came to this earth that was worth, was slept on, born into poverty among the oppressed and stepped on. He took on human form and his life was ransomed. Prophecy fulfilled, birthed the plan of creation. Through the scarlet thread of redemption would come our salvation. This babe was slain before the world's foundation. The purpose of his life bent towards heaven's orientation. From eternity, the Lord has loved his people. Displayed through this Christmas babe, given the holy name of Jesus. From the manger to the grave, the cost of his love. The resurrection and the ascension, the triumph of our hope. So let us rejoice with the heavens, for unto us this child was born. And unto us he gave his only son. Heaven has come. Heaven has come. Heaven has come.
Dawn of salvation. Darkness reigns no more, for Jesus is greater. He is greater. Angels
Merry Christmas to you, great city.
Ah, yes, a holly jolly holiday to you and yours. My name is Joel.
And I'm Evan, and we are your heavenly hosts for the evening.
Hallelujah!
Hallelujah!
Hallelujah! Hallelujah! Hallelujah!
Hallelujah! We're really starting to get the hang of that, buddy. Nice job.
It's not bad.
It's good.
Tonight, we feel so honored to join you in your homes. Although it's hard not to be together physically with those we love, we know that we are united around something greater than the presence and the pleasantries. We are a family, held together by the hope of Jesus Christ, our Savior and our King.
That's right, Brother Joel. So tonight, we come with a message of good news that will cause great joy for all the people of Grace City. A Savior has been born to us. He is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find reminders of His goodness and grace through the songs that we sing, the smiles we share, and the stories we tell tonight.
Our mission is to fill your home with the peace and joy of Jesus as we celebrate His birth together. First things first, we'd love to introduce you to some people in our Grace City family who'll be sharing traditions passed down through their families to help them celebrate this season.
Yo, Gabriel, roll the tape.
And a one, and a two, and a
hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. That's good.
Hey, Grace City.
We're the Maison family.
We're the Thomas family.
We are the Kaze family.
We are the Harris Nation.
So our tradition with our family is every Christmas Eve, we make Rice Krispie treats so that we can eat them the next morning as we're opening up our presents.
Some of our family traditions that we do every year is we watch Elf together. We find it to be funny still every year. And Christmas Vacation we also do. I've done that since I was little, so I thought we would all do it together as they grow up.
On Christmas Eve, our family goes to my dad's house and we have taco soup and sing Christmas carols and read the Christmas story. And
eat cookies
and have dinner.
So growing up, we didn't really have too many family traditions, but I knew that we wanted to start our own as our family. And so we decided that every year we are going to make cookies. Yeah, we're gonna make cookies around Christmas. And it's just gonna be time for us to slow down with the family, take some time, and enjoy each other.
Yeah, and it's a new tradition. We haven't really done it before, but we have a baby now, so why not start something fun and yummy?
I think it's the tradition started after we got married because I did not have a Christmas tradition, and we watched Elf together, and that's when it became the Kaze tradition. Mm-hmm.
This tradition started about 20 years ago, and just all the family came together and just really had a good time connecting.
So this tradition started when I was growing up. I used to make Rice Krispie treats with my dad and brothers the night before Christmas, and it was just something fun that we could do together in the kitchen that wasn't too complicated.
We love this time with our family because some of them we only get to see once a year. And so this is a great time to catch up and see what we've been up to all year. Just really appreciate each other and the growth, literally the growth and multiplying of our family. And so it's a really, really special time.
Again, it's moments like this that helps us slow down and enjoy family and think about family more, you know? So it's a simple movie tradition that helps us to think of life and the slow paced, yeah.
I think this helps us. It helps us to, it's something to look forward to, right? And I think that oftentimes with the kids, we talk about the joy that we have in our walk and our relationship with Christ and what we have to look forward to. So I think every year with this tradition, we look forward to going out and getting the ingredients and adding all kinds of treats to it, from sprinkles to M&Ms to Reese's, whatever you call it, we add it to that, and it's something that we look forward to. So it helps us to remind the kids that we have a lot to look forward to in our walk and our relationship with Christ.
This tradition allows us to be all together, to slow down, to take time, and to really enjoy this time of season where we get to just be with family and enjoy this guy. Yeah, what do you have to say?
Man, I love those cookies. Mm-mm. They look delicious. I may have to stop by the Maison House tonight.
Ooh, good idea. Grab me one too. I loved hearing about all those amazing traditions. You know what one of my favorite traditions up here is?
Bobbing for apples?
Brother Joel, how many times do I have to tell you? We must not eat the apple. My favorite is the annual Christmas sweater party. And since there's no such thing as ugly in heaven, we always look fresh.
You know what?
What?
Fit change.
Hey!
Oh, snap! Bro, we look the same.
Yeah.
But different.
Yeah.
Speaking of different, this year definitely looked different for us as a church family. We weren't able to gather and celebrate the way we traditionally have in the past, but we were able to hold on to the aspects of our culture that we value by infusing abundant joy and defiant faith into all that we did. This is who we are, Grace City. It was awesome to start some new traditions with you this December.
Let's take a walk down memory lane. It started with Light Up the Night. We drove around Corvallis, dropping off canned goods and enjoying the festive lights. Because of our collective contributions, we were able to deliver a surplus of food to the school district of their emergency food boxes, benefiting families with food insecurities over the holiday season. We came back together to sing carols and take in the wonder of our first annual Christmas tree lighting, which has shone bright all month long at our new Miracle Church building. It's been fun to watch people from our community drive by and check out what's going on over here at 4000 Western Boulevard.
That night, we selected items to purchase for five local families who have experienced especially hard times lately to bless them with a December to remember. We each took care of one thing, be it a Lego sets, a wrapping paper, or a Christmas ham, and packaged it all up to be delivered this week. We loved working towards something bigger than ourselves this season. Generosity, partnered with the love of Jesus, never gets old.
Lastly, we saw you rise up and grab hold of Jesus for yourselves this month. Prayer groups continue to meet and are experiencing God's power and love in remarkable ways. We have blown past our original 100-hour goal, and we aren't looking back. And we've opened our Bibles each day and read through our Advent calendar, remembering to rejoice in all circumstances. These choices don't look flashy or significant, but we believe that they are the daily decisions that deeply matter and continue to build a legacy that not only impacts our personal lives, but our community for eternity.
Yes, looking back, December was different, but it had a purpose, and God made it matter. Thank you for walking with us through it all, even if we had to be 6 feet apart.
Wait, do you hear that? The bells.
Yeah, buddy, you bet I do.
Common misunderstanding. Many people think that every time a bell rings, an actual angel gets its wings. But it actually means we're just up here having a dance party.
And boy, do we love dance parties. Let's ask a few of our kids from Mid-City and City High to join in on the fun.
Bushels of fun. Now the jingle hop has begun. Jingle bell, jingle bell, jingle bell rock. Jingle bells chime and jingle bell time. Dancing and prancing in Jingle Bell Square. In the frosty air. What a bright time.
jingle horse, pick up your feet, jingle up around the clock. Mix and a mingle in the jingling feet, that's the jingle bell rock. Gliding in the one horse sleigh. Giddy up, jingle horse, pick up your feet, jingle up around the clock. Mix and a mingle in the jingling feet, that's the jingle bell, that's the jingle bell, that's the jingle bell rock.
Nice. Nice job.
Hark! That was a blast! Amazing job, kids. Thanks for grooving with us. Wow. I love your pajamas, Evan.
Oh, thanks, Brother Joel. I like yours too. They're, holy.
Yes, they are. Okay. It's time to slow things down a bit. We've got some good news to talk about, so come a little closer. We're headed on a tour through town to stop by a few homes with some friendly faces you might recognize. Our first stop will be Wes and Maya Sheeler's house, where we all join in on a family Christmas carol by the fire.
Then we'll stop by the Paulsons to hear the Christmas story.
We'll take a right turn and drop by church to worship with the Grace City worship team.
And circle back to the Trimmer's house for a Christmas cookie and encouraging word.
Oh, sweet heavens. You know I love cookies.
I knew that'd get you.
Are you ready?
Let's go.
Let's do it.
O come, Emmanuel, and ransom captive Israel, who mourns in lowly exile here, until the Son of God appears. O come, thou day spring, come and cheer our spirits by thine aventure. Disperse the gloomy clouds of night, in death's dark shadows put to flight. Rejoice, rejoice, Emmanuel shall come to thee, O Israel. O come, desire of nations, bind all peoples of one heart and mind. Bid envy, strife, and quarrels cease, and fill the whole world with heaven's peace. Rejoice, rejoice, shall come to thee, O Israel. Rejoice, rejoice, Emmanuel shall come to thee, O Israel.
Oh, hey there. Good evening, Grace City. Merry Christmas Eve. I thought tonight would be a great time to read a Christmas story. So if you want to join me over here by the fire, we'll get started. Okay. Tonight we are going to be reading The Christmas Story. Here we go. The Christmas Story began a long time ago, but it didn't begin with a baby. It began with a promise. God made a promise after Adam and Eve, the first people, disobeyed him and sin darkened the world. God promised that someday someone would come to bring light into the dark world. Many years later, God promised a man named Abraham that his family would have more people in it than there are bright stars in the dark sky. And one of those people would bring light into the dark world. Abraham believed, and he praised God. Abraham's family grew bigger and bigger, just like God had promised. They became the nation of Israel, and they asked God to give them a king. So God chose a boy from a little town called Bethlehem to be their king. His name was David. David was a very good king, but the world was still dark. Then God promised David that someone in his family would be the one who would bring light into the dark world. David believed, and he praised God. Many years later, God told a man named Isaiah to give a very special message to his people. The light of the world is coming. Isaiah believed, and he praised God. Isaiah told people that the one who was coming would be God himself. God would come to them as a baby. The baby would be called Emmanuel, which means God with us. So the people waited and waited and waited and waited and waited and waited for 400 more years. Then one day, an angel named Gabriel told a young woman named Mary that she was going to have a baby. Mary was scared, but the angel told her not to be afraid. Gabriel said that Mary's child was a gift from God, the light of the world God had promised his people. Mary believed, and she praised God. Mary was engaged to a man named Joseph. The angel also visited him in a dream. He told Joseph that the baby was from God, and he should name the baby Jesus. Joseph believed, and he praised God. Joseph was from the family of Abraham and King David. God was keeping his promises to them. Because of a law, Mary and Joseph needed to travel to Joseph's hometown. While they were there, it was time for Mary to have the baby. Into the darkness, after all that waiting, the light of the world was born. This is the Christmas story. Mary wrapped Jesus up in a blanket and laid him in a manger where animals were fed. That same night, some shepherds were watching their sheep in a field nearby. Suddenly, angels filled the dark sky, singing because Jesus was born. Glory to God in the highest. The shepherds hurried to find Jesus. He was right where the angels said he would be. The shepherds believed, and they praised God. Later, wise men called magi saw a bright star in the sky. They followed the star across the desert. They found Jesus, the light of the world. The wise men believed, and they praised God. We celebrate Christmas because Jesus came to be the light of the world. The Christmas story began with a promise, but it also ends with one. Jesus, the light who came into the dark world, promises that one day he will return. And the world will never be dark again. We believe and we praise God. The end. Thanks for joining me, Grace City. Merry Christmas.
Hark the herald angels sing, glory to the newborn King, peace on earth and mercy mild, God and sinners reconcile. Joyful all ye nations rise, join the triumph of the skies with angelic hosts proclaim.
Oh, holy night, the stars are brightly shining. It is the night of our dear Savior's birth.
For the slave is our brother.
Merry Christmas Eve, everybody. This is Pastor Seth, and I'm here with a special guest. The lovely lady to my right is my spouse.
Merry Christmas.
This is Hannah, if you haven't met her before, and welcome to our living room. I wanted to take a moment just to acknowledge about what a crazy year 2020 has been. I realize many of you have been through some really challenging and hard times, and maybe some really wild adventures. And I'm sure many of you have had to solve problems that you've literally never encountered before. And there's a pretty decent chance, if you're a Jesus follower, that you've asked him for wisdom and you've been asking him for guidance and strength and help and all kinds of ways that are fresh and new and unprecedented for your life. And so because of all those things, this is just a year of mixed bags. And we realize a lot has been taken away and there's been a lot of stress and strain, but God has been faithful. And if there was ever a doubt of the strength of Grace City as a church, if there was ever doubts as to the resiliency of our community, I think that's been answered well. And you all are an amazing people, and you are generous, and you are kind, and you are faithful, and you have been flexible, and you have been faith-filled and prayerful. All the things that I know really bless Jesus and are helping to demonstrate his kingdom here really well in the city and around this campus and so forth. So I just want to say a heartfelt thank you to all of you. I hope this new year coming involves lots of God's favor and blessings, but come what may, we'll trust that he'll remain with us, and we'll remember during this Christmas season the beautiful gift of Emmanuel, and we'll take it all the way through no matter what comes in the next year. So God bless you. I love you. And from the Trimmer home to yours, Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas. We love you.
What an amazing night, Grace City. Thank you for joining us from wherever you are. Our prayer for you this month has been and will continue to be that you'll experience the peace and joy that comes from Jesus alone. He is good and he is with us.
Well said, Evan. It reminds me of what my old Uncle Harold used to say. Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth, peace to those on whom his favor rests.
Amen. Oh boy, you hear the bells are back? It's time to boogie. Thanks for tuning in. Merry Christmas, Grace City.
Merry Christmas, family. And a one, and a two, and a...
Snowing and blowing up bushels of fun. Now the jingle hop has begun. Giddy up, jingle bell rock. Jingle bells rock. Snowing and prancing, jingle bell square. In the frosty air, what a right time, it's a right time.
All right.